Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. marks a fifth day of his working visit in New York with meetings with foreign leaders, among them Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. During their meeting, the Prime Minister vowed to support the Marcos administration's bid to make the Philippines an upper middle-income country. Marcos also met with former British Prime Minister Tony Blair. They talked primarily about the peace process in the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao. As for his meeting with executives of American Global Food Corporation Cargill, Marcos said they discussed ways to attain food security. Meanwhile, improving bilateral economic ties with other countries was among the agenda in a business dialogue attended by the president.
We really have to leverage whatever assets, whatever capabilities, whatever we have, so that we can maximize our ability to grow and to pull the economy. Let us find new ways. Let us find new ways to partner. Let us find new ways to develop. Let us find new ways to strengthen this relationship between the United States, ASEAN, and the Philippines.
Marcos is also scheduled to meet with U.S. President Joe Biden.
Rights advocates disappointed over President Marcos' speech before the UN General Assembly. They questioned Marcos' claim that the country is on the road to become middle income status by 2023. The groups believe his statements about the Philippines did not reflect the realities on the ground.
Hypocritical na pag-usapan yung mga yon kasi yung kanyang personal and political practice ay taliwas dito. Exact opposite siya. Kung titignan natin halimbawa yung kanyang kauna-unang budget, kinaltasan na mahigit 42 billion pesos yung ayuda sa 2023 budget. Kinaltasan na halos 2 billion piso ang mga micro, small and medium enterprises. Kinaltasan ang budget para sa tertiary education. Maging sa mga public budget sa mga ospital ay binawasan.
The United Nations urges the Philippine government to take immediate action in achieving sustainable development goals. To hit those goals, the UN's coordinator in the Philippines, Gustavo Gonzalez, says the government cannot take a business-as-usual approach. He also hopes the government would integrate those goals into its planning in the coming years.
We look at these global, regional, and country challenges to the SDGs from the lens of our core agenda, which is to leave no one behind. And in practical terms, this means reducing inequalities in all its form. With this in mind, I would like to take this opportunity to invite you to reflect on some issues of inequality that are reflected in the topic of our webinar today on the triple bottom line, and you call it social inequalities facing our people, environmental inequalities that arise from impacts on our planet, and economic inequalities that result due to the focus on profit.
The UN fears countries in the Asia-Pacific region, including the Philippines, are not on track to hit the 2030 deadline. The 17 Sustainable Development Goals set by the UN include eliminating poverty, ending hunger, achieving quality education, and gender equality.